Let's offer this time in prayer, and would you join me in prayer? Lord, thank you so much for this time that you have gathered us again all together, Lord, that we may be able to study your word, to dive deep, O Lord, and to see your heart with regards to our salvation. Father, we ask that you quicken our hearts, O God, quicken our minds to learn from you, to reflect on our lives, and Father, to apply all the things that we are about to learn. Lord, we pray for our brothers and sisters who are on their way. May you guide them, Lord. May you guide their feet and bless them as they come here. May we not go out of this room without anything in our life. Lord, transform our lives for our good and for your glory in Christ's name. Amen. Okay. So tonight we're going to discuss about the promise of the assurance of our salvation. Okay. By the way, I'm Conrad, and very quiet lahat. Okay, I'm Conrad, and 9 years na ako dito sa Singapore. I'm working in a construction industry. So I'm married to my wife, Jacqueline, my beautiful wife. So for 2 years, going to 2 years na, and both of us working in a construction industry. So for about a decade in construction, there's one thing that I have learned, that the, one of the most important element of every structure is the foundation. So not tonight. And imagine nyo yung inyong dream house. Napakalaki, napakaganda, very expensive. At talagang pinag-isipan mabuti. But imagine if this house is seated on a 2-inch slab, on a 2-inch foundation. Hindi niya kayang i-carry yung load. Eventually, magko-collapse yung bahay. Sayang yung ganda ng bahay nyo. Sayang yung lahat ng mga investments. So, it is very important that the foundation is deep, is wide, and is strong. So, this is the thing with our spiritual journey. It's very important that our foundation spiritually is stable. It is the goal and aim of CCF and in GLC that every believer, every Christian, and everyone who's attending our church is rooted at the foundation that can only be found in the scriptures, in Bible alone. So, ito yung ginagawa natin ngayon. So, for the past 4 weeks, we have discussed about to make a review, short review. First, Kuya Mario discussed about one truth. Okay. About the gospel of Christ. He started with the character of God, that God is holy God. He is holy, He is righteous. There's justice in God. He is eternally perfect. But, point number two, we have a problem. And the problem is, all of us are sinners. Lahat tayo fail the standard of God. But, what is the right, ano dapat gawin nitong holy God to a sinner like you and me? It is a rightful that iano tayo, punish tayo ni God. It is just rightful. But at the same time, on the other hand, God is also loving. His loving is gracious and is merciful. That's why God provided a way for us to be saved. And it can only be found in Jesus Christ. So, with that, what is the man's rightful response to the calling of God, to the love of God? It is just right for us that we repent of our sin, turn away from our sin, turn away from ourselves, and to put our faith in Christ, the only solution in our sin. So, Kuya Mario gives us a panoramic view of the gospel from Genesis to Revelation. It all goes around sa point na ito, that God is holy, that we have a problem, but God is also loving on the other end. And we have to respond accordingly to the calling of the Lord. Then, 2 weeks ago, Kuya Joy zooms in dito sa God is love. Who is He? It's Jesus Christ. That there's only one way. There's only one Savior. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Jesus never say na, I am a way, I am a truth, or I am a life, which gives an implication that there are many other options. But God, Jesus is very exclusive when He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. If papunta kayo ng Tampines, there are lots of way going to Tampines or to your house. But with regards to going to the Father, it's only through Jesus Christ. Paul also says in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 5, for there is one God and there is one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Okay. Then last week, one proof, our new life in Christ. So since we are in Christ na, we became His sons and daughters. And we are already rooted in Christ. And as we grow, there are also fruits that are expected of us. That when you are in Christ, you are a new creature. The old has gone, the new has come. And at the same time, God also gave us the fruit of the Holy Spirit. He said that love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. All these were given to us the moment that we repented of our sin and put our faith in Christ. So the things that we love, the things that we loved before, that is not honoring before God, ayaw na natin nung because we are already a new creature. So before, ayaw natin yung mga things of God. But when we became a new creature, all the things that God loves, we love to do. And all the things that God hates, ayaw na din natin. So this is our new life in Christ. And it also says that we are to obey Him. Jesus said in John chapter 14, verse 15, that if you love me, you will obey my commands. So one of the proof of being a Christian is our obedience in Him. Okay. But the reality sets in. Sometimes we have to love. God commanded us to love. But sometimes we fail. And we fail miserably. Instead na yung brothers mo or yung sister mo is mahalin mo. Sometimes you're being angry with them because of some expectations, disappointments. Sometimes is you react differently sa kanila. And at the same time, you have to be joyful in all things, but you cannot help but be anxious. God says that you're going to have peace, but then what happens is sometimes tayo pa yung nagsisimula, nag-iignite ng fire, and we fail. We fail terribly on certain times. And tatulungin natin sa sarili natin, am I really saved? Saved kaya talaga ako? Can I trust the Word of God? Can I trust that once I have put my faith in Him, He will save me? Okay, let's go to the first point. Let's look at the character of God. God is immutable. May kita ba lang dyan? Can everybody see? Okay. God is immutable. It means that God never changes. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. So He never changed. So once He promised that you are in Christ, you are a new creature, there is no turning back. Let's read one of the passage, Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5 to 6. One, two, three, go.
Live your life free from love of money and be content with what you have. For he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you.
So we can confidently say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear.
What can man do to me?
What can man do to me? Nauli akong magbasa. Gandang promise. Gandang promise. Kaya lang, at the same time, ano ba yung context niya? What, how is God being immutable sa part na to? How did God never change sa part na to? Well, I highlighted, I will never leave you nor forsake you. But what's the whole context? Okay, I'll be needing three brothers. Si Yada. Ada, stand here sa gitna. Ay, dito sa akin dito. And si Wilmer, pati dito. John, can I borrow you? Oh, bro, dito ka. Ay, John, dito. Okay, thank you. So now, dito tayo sa, we are here at the present. We're at 2017. Ay, Kuya Wilmer tayo. When we read the passage, well, it's very encouraging that God will never leave us nor forsake us. I mean, what can we, no? God is our helper. What can man do to me? Pero when we read during the author of Hebrew, kanya niya to, in-address niya to dun sa mga Jewish people. And it was written about 2,000 years ago. So when we go, magba-back to the future tayo. Ito yung present. Ito yung past. This is the time that 2,000 years ago, when the author of Hebrews wrote to the Jewish people. Ang sabi, keep your life free from the love of money and be content with what you have. For he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. During the time of the Jewish, there are a minority group who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. And they were being persecuted by the majority of the Hebrews who don't believe in Jesus. Some of their, yung ari-arian nila, has been taken away from them. Some of them were being imprisoned. And some of them were being executed. Other than being persecuted by their fellow countrymen, they are also oppressed by the Roman Empire. So kaya yung author of Hebrews is writing to the Jewish people that keep your life free from the love of money and be content with what you have. For he has said. Sino yung he has said? Sino yung sabi? Sinabi yun during the time of Moses. So again, this is 2,000 years ago. Okay. Then we're going back another 1,500 years, give or take, during the time of Moses. Okay. During the time of Moses, in Deuteronomy chapter 31, verse 6, Moses said to the Israelites, be strong and courageous. Do not fear or be in dread of them, for it is the Lord your God who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. So, what's the story during this time? Okay, the story during this time is that you've heard about the Exodus from the Israelites from the Egypt. Then they cross the Red Sea. And they were about to go to the Promised Land. Bibigay sa kanila ni God. Kaya lang, sabi ni God, Moses cannot go dun sa Promised Land. So Moses is about to die. And Moses is about to die. So the group leader of the Israelites is about to die. Tapos, so they're very in dread. And natatakot sila. They're very fearful. Kasi dun sa Promised Land, they're also waiting na itong mga Amorites, mga Edomites, mga Jebusites, Perizzites, at kung sino-sino mga parasites. And then, so because these people have heard about what God has done to them during the Exodus. So they are threatened. Kaya ngayon, they plan to attack them, to mga Israelites, that they don't want the Israelites to go to the promised land. So, naging fearful yung mga tao din. Kaya sabi, kaya again, Moses told them, be strong and courageous. Do not fear or be in dread of them. For it is the Lord your God who goes with you. He will not leave you or forsake you. And then, after that, few chapters, Joshua chapter 1, verse 5. Wala na si Moses sa picture. And the Israelites is about to cross the promised land. And God appeared to Joshua, saying, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. Just as I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you or forsake you. So if you're going to connect yung context, God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Okay? Kabag tayo sa forever. May forever, ha? Okay. So, but even before, during the Deuteronomy, sinabi na din kay Jacob before. Genesis chapter 20, verse 15, sinabi na, I will not leave you until I am done with you. Until I finish, until yung purpose ko sa iyo would succeed. I will not leave you. So, it is an encouragement to the Israelites. So now, andito na tayo ulit sa present, 2017. Sabi dito, keep your life free from the love of money and be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So we can confidently say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man do to me? So paano natin i-apply ito ngayon in our life? So I believe most of us are working. Yon, so most of us are working, and sometimes we experience struggle din sa work. Sometimes sa mga boss or sa mga colleague. I-apply, paano ba natin i-apply? Punta natin yung colleague natin. O yung boss. Boss, the Lord is on my side. He is my helper. I will not fear. What can you do to me? Is that how are we going to apply yung passage? Or sabihin natin sa husband or wife natin, honey, the Lord is on my side. Is it the right application? Or can we just say that, sit on our table, maybe, and pray, Lord, I know that you will never leave me. That even if I'm persecuted, that even if I'm having a hard time dito sa mga kulig ko, I know that you are with me. You are encouraging me with your word. I know that you are with me. What can man do to me? I should not fear. Lord, since you are on my side, and I am on your side, would you bring them also to your side? Para magkakasama kayo. Which is a better na application? Okay? Hello? Yes. Thank you, brothers. Thank you so much. Palakpakan niyo naman yung mga brothers. So, what then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things pertaining to our spiritual, to spiritual things, to spiritual blessings. So, ngayon, tatanungin natin, is God really for me? What if I sin? What if nag-fail ako? Is God still on my side? Or ayaw na sa akin ni God kasi I sin? Yan, di na tayo bate. Okay. Is God still on your side, or i-abandon na kayo ni God because you sin? Okay. Now, hold it for a moment. Let me say to you that God is still for you, and He is not against you. Later, balikan natin yun, ha? Ngayon, punta tayo din sa nature of our relationship with God. Ano ba yung nature ng relationship natin with God? Let's first start establish what's the difference between relationship and... Nakikita niyan? What's the difference between relationship and fellowship? Who can share? Sige, volunteer na lang ako. Okay. Sino may mga anak na? Okay, ako wala pa. Okay, so, example na lang natin yung sa ako. Salimbawa, may anak ako. And his name is Junior. Ganda, pinag-isipan ko mabuti yun. Okay. So, si Junior is bagong panganak. So, maliit. So, bata pa siya. Ang relationship namin is I'm the father and he is the son. What if nag-grade 6 na siya? Did it changes? May sagot yan. Oh no, okay. Then, what if nag-college na siya? Nagbago ba? Hindi. Anak na ako siya ngayon tatay. What if mas malaki na siya sa akin? Ano ko pa din siya? What if nag-asawa na siya? Ano ko pa din siya? What if may anak na siya? Is he my grandson na?
No.
So he's still my son. Never change. What if si Junior is an obedient son? Lahat ng inuutos ko sa kanya is talagang sinusunod niya. Lagi pang may pating when you give him. Kumusta yung relationship namin? Kumusta yung fellowship namin? Mas maganda. Mas na-enjoy namin yung one another. What if nag-grow na siya and naging matigas ang ulo? He became disobedient. Sabi niya, lahat mo sasabihin ko. Lahat ayaw. Sabi ko, kung mag-aasawa ka, like your mom. Lahat maganda. Wala siyang napangasawang ganun. Wala siyang makita. So, ako, naging disobedient yung anak ko. Is he still my son?
Yes.
What if he goes to Singapore? He goes back to the Philippines. Is he still my son?
Yes.
But, kamusta yung fellowship namin? Kamusta yung relationship namin? Kamusta yung intimacy namin? Are we intimate? No. What if, alimbawa, nakulong siya? Is he still my son? But, kamusta kaya yung fellowship namin with one another? It's missing. Nami-miss mo yung fellowship or yung intimacy nyo. As a father and son, you're not enjoying the relationship that you have. So, kung titingnan natin, the relationship, it's a permanent. It never changes. Whatever happens, still the same. It never changes. But yung fellowship, it changes. It varies. Temporary. Relationship, it is your position. If you are a daughter or a son to your parents, it will never change. But yung condition nung life nyo is how is your intimacy with your parents or with your father. Same with God. Okay? With the Lord, the moment that you accepted Him, the moment that you have repented of your sin and you put your faith in Christ, you are in a relationship with God. You are in a permanent and it never changes. But ang nagbabago is yung condition. Nagbabago is yung intimacy nyo with God the Father. Okay po ba?
Okay.
Nakasunod ha? Okay. Let's read from the passage of Luke 15, verses 11 to 24. Ladies, can you start?
And he said, there was a man who had two sons. The younger man said to his father, Father, give me the share of property that is coming to me. And he divided his property between them. Not many days later, the younger son gathered all he had and took a journey to a far country. And there he squandered his property in reckless living.
Gentlemen.
In Germany, you have spent everything, consider your family and your rules in their harmony, and be begun to be in need.
Since the Lord then had hired himself out the one of the citizens of that country, who sent him into his fields to be in peace.
And he was longing to be fed with the flowers and the leaves, and no one gave him anything.
But when he came to himself, he said, "How many of my father's hired servants have more than enough bread, but I perish here with hunger?
I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, 'Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you.
I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Treat me as one of your hired servants.'"
He made a rose and came to his father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and felt compassion, and had an embracing him and kissed him.
And the son said to him, "Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son."
But the father said to his servants, "Bring with me the best robe and put it on him, and put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet.
And bring the fattened cup and kill it, and let us eat and celebrate.
For this my son was dead, and he was alive again. He was lost and was found, and they began to celebrate."
Amen. This is the picture of your relationship and fellowship. So we have seen that the son has a relationship with the father. He is a son. Kahit na anong gawin niya, it never changes. But what happened is the quality of their relationship, which is yung intimacy nila. You see, he squandered all yung belongings na tatay niya, which is kinuha niya agad. It's a disrespect in our culture and even on them. Pero ayun yung ginawa niya. But the father is a loving. Kahit na anong ginawa ng anak niya against him, still he embraced yung anak niya the moment that this son returned to him. Okay. So, and the moment that bumalik siya dun sa father niya, the fellowship has been restored. Well, ito last week is last time na discuss ni Danny Joy, I remember. So, ayun, this is one of the things that makikita natin na yung tayo, yung relationship natin with God, we are already there. However, we're losing yung fellowship, yung quality of relationship when we disobey or when we disregard, dishonor our Father in heaven. Okay? So that is our relationship and fellowship. Any questions? Wala. Okay, nakalimutan ko pala sabihin kanina, sorry. Okay. You can list at least 3 things that you are going to learn for tonight. And then, mamaya sa breakout group, ayun yung i-discuss nyo, i-share nyo with one another. List at least 3 things that. And if kailangan nyo ng papel and pen, naging very excited ako kanina. Meron tayo dito. Sinong kailangan ng paper and pen? Thank you, Kuya Jun. Sorry. Okay, now, what is the very thing that is hindering, what is the very thing that is hindering our fellowship with God? Huh? Ano pa? Sin. Tama naman. Sin. Now, sin is the very thing that keeps us away from enjoying our fellowship with God. It is sin. Pero ngayon, what is sin? Ano bang ibig sabihin? Well, the very basic definition of sin is missing the mark, missing the target point, missing the bullseye. So it's, ito, you hit the bullseye. But, sometimes you miss. So this is considered as sin. What if, not even close? Okay. Then who sets the mark? Who is setting the standard? See? Si God. God is setting the standard. Paano mo malalaman? How can we know? In the Bible.
Very good, siya. Thank you.
Thank you, Michelle. Good. So, God is setting the mark. God is setting the bullseye or the target for us. And it can only be found in the Bible. Let's say, itong lips natin, or our tongue, or our mouth, what is God's design? What is God's aim or target with regards to our lips? Maliban sa kumain. Guard your tongue. Pagkain ulit. Salamat sa Big Mac. Sarap. Okay. Okay. So, ladies, please read. Brothers, please read Ephesians 5, chapter 4.
Let there be no filthiness nor foolish talk, nor worldly boasting, which are out of place, but that there be sanctity.
Balik tayo dito, ha? Ephesians 4:29. What is God's aim sa atin? Let no corrupting talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is good for building up.
Yung kulit ko, napakaano. Hindi maintindihan.
Experience yung ganun? I'm not going to ask for a show of hands, ha?
Sabi ko, yung boss ko, mas magaling pa ako dun. Hindi ko maintindihan kung bakit siya naging boss.
Is it building up? Are you trying? Nakakabila pa siya? And at the same time, that, sabi nito that it may give grace to those who hear. Is the one na nakakarinig ba nun is receiving grace? No. I'm not going to ask for a show of hands. Okay? Sabi, let there be no filthiness, nor foolish talk, nor crude joking, which are out of place, but instead, let there be thanksgiving. Are we being thankful of all the things that we have and even the things that we don't have? Or are we just enjoying or making fun of others and sometimes degrading or it's not encouraging sa tao? But what is God's design? Okay, if you're going to reflect on your own life just for now, or maybe this morning, did you hit the spot? Did you hit the target? Or did you miss a bit? Not even close. Every time na nakikita ko ito, natatawa ko. Lagi kasi ako nandito. Favorite spot. Oh yeah. Okay, what about God's design in our mind? To this 3-pound fat of our mind. Anong design ni God? Oh, si Connie, nagtaas ng kamay. Okay. Sabi dito, ladies ulit. Ladies, please read.
Mankind and brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is any worthy of praise, think about the
there are 8 points there. Whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence or anything worthy of praise, Paul says, think about these things. if I have a microchip in here and I implant dun sa brain ng each one of us and to record maybe for just one whole day and then kukunin ko ulit sa inyo yung microchip, are you confident if papalabas natin dito what runs through your thoughts the whole day? I'm not confident. Magulo yung utak ko. Baka ano. Ano yun? So, lahat tayo, oh, I don't know about you, kung na-hit niyo yung target for today. Is it close? Or not at all? Or you missed totally the mark? So, ito dalawa pa lang ito ah. Dalawa pa lang itong example that God has designed that we all fail. But then, we are still in a relationship with God. It never changes yung position natin before God. What changes is yung fellowship. But then, babalik ulit tayo. How is God dealing with us when we commit sin? First, our actions will have consequences. Sabi sa Galatians chapter 6, do not be deceived. God is not mocked, for what one sows that will he also reap. For the one who sows to his own flesh will from the flesh reap corruption. But the one who sows to the Spirit will from the Spirit reap eternal life. And we are free dun sa mga to make choices. We are free to make choices. We are free to do good. We are free to obey God. But the thing is, we are not free from the consequences of our actions. If you manage to obey God, you will reap kung ano yung blessing or kung ano yung you will reap yung consequence nun. But when you disobey God, ganun din. It's the same. So, it is are we going to continue to pacify our passing pleasures? Or are we going to leave a lasting legacy? Do you want to invest on the things that is temporary and eventually mawawala din? Or you're going to invest on the things that have eternal value? God is asking that we as a Christians, as children of God, is to invest dun sa may eternal value. Because the most na we can live here on earth about how many years? 18, 19. And then after that is eternal. Pakahaba na. Hindi ko mabilang. Yun. So, you're going to reap what you sow. So, I challenge each one of us that we invest our time and effort in the things that have eternal value. Next. Any questions? Pala? Alam kung maayos ba yung pagtuturo or hindi naiintindihan ng lahat ng lahat. Alright. Clear naman. Ay, nakaka-encourage naman ka. Thank you. Ayun. So, next is God disciplines His children. Are you God's children?
Yes.
Of course, when you're God's child, God will discipline you. If hindi kayo discipline ni God, then illegitimate ka, ampun, or God doesn't care at all. But be grateful that God disciplines you. Hebrews chapter 12, verses 9 to 11. Besides this, we have had earthly fathers who disciplined us, and we respected them. Shall we not much more be subject to the Father of the spirits and live? For they, our earthly fathers, are your earthly parents. For they disciplined us for a short time, as it seemed best to them. But he, God the Father disciplines us for our good. Why? That we may share His holiness. For the moment, all discipline seems painful rather than pleasant, but later it yields the peaceful fruit of righteousness to those who have been trained by it. God is not enjoying disciplining you then. Well, but wait, no, no. So God is iPad. Naligaw na ako. God is disciplining us not for His pleasure, but that we may share His holiness. It is all the things happen for our good and for God's glory. Nothing out of it is, kumbaga, i-credit natin sa sarili natin or sabihin natin si God is pinapayarapan tayo or God is just making fun of us and na-enjoy niya na mag-suffer tayo do sa mga consequences, no? But God have to discipline us because He is our Father, that we may share in His holiness. Proverbs 3:11-12. My son, do not despise the Lord's discipline or be weary of His reproof. Why? For the Lord reproves him whom He loves, as a father the son in whom He delights. Is God delighted in you? God is delighted in you. That's why He reproves you. Okay. Okay lang, ha? Okay. So, who wants discipline? Discipline chair. The Lord reproves him whom He loves. Know that God loves you. That's why you're experiencing discipline at times that you disobey Him. Okay. Point number 3 is that believers do not continue or want to sin. First John chapter 3, verse 6. No one who abides in Him keeps on sinning. No one keeps on sinning has either seen Him or known Him. If you remain in Christ, tendencies are you just yung ayaw nyo nang mag-sin. Magiging normal instinct na that when you fall into sin, when you realize something that, oops, parang hindi ito yung design ni God for me, then straight away, sabihin nyo na, hindi tama to. Hindi tama na ginagawa ko to. Hindi ko dapat ina-enjoy. Otherwise, if hindi ganun yung nararamdaman nyo or na-feel nyo, sabi, no one who keeps on sinning has either seen Him or known Him. If hindi ka nakaka-experience ng konting kurot dun sa sin, there's a big problem. Okay. So, verse 9 says, no one born of God makes a practice of sinning. For God's sins abide in him, and he cannot keep on sinning because he has been born of God. It doesn't mean that every Christian is sinless. Okay? It means that Christian sinless. Yeah? Christian is not sinless, but sins less. Nagbabawasan na nagbabawasan yung pag-sin natin. It's like a baby. And baby, syempre, pag nag-start pa lang siya maglakad, madadapa. But as he mature in age and in yung strength niya, lesser and lesser na yung tendencies na nagpo-fall siya. In the same way, yung spiritual life din natin, as we mature, the first that naging Christian tayo is, we fail, talagang sometimes consistent pa,
na-enjoy pa natin minsan. Pero as we grow, as we mature, nare-realize natin na, uy, baga parang hindi na tama ito. So, hindi ka consciously or hindi mo pinapractice to sin. Hindi mo ina-enjoy to sin. Okay, with that, sa mga things na yun, practical application. Lahat tayo is nag-sin. Lahat tayo fails at one point. Lahat tayo disobeys God. Lahat tayo rebels against God. But nakita din natin kung paano dinideal ni God yung mga sins natin. So with that, how what's our practical application is to confess. 1 John 1:9 says, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from some unrighteousness. Some, hindi ba some? All. Okay. Sabi, if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So it's all. Now the premise, sabi dito, the premise is if you confess your sin. And ang promise is again the character of God that He is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If you confess your sin. This is the premise and the promise. If you confess your sin, God is faithful and just to forgive our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Ano muna tayo? What is confession? What is confess? Okay. Confess in Greek is and transliterated as homologeo. Correct the target?
Homologeo.
Okay. Much more technical. Okay. Homo means one or the same. Okay. And logeo or logos is word. Comes from logos, word. So, homo logeo, confess is one word, the same word. Teka, parang it doesn't make sense. It doesn't add up. But if you, one word. But, ang ibig sabihin niyan is you are agreeing with the word. Remember kanina that God sets the mark, God sets the bullseye. Diba? But this is the word, and you are agreeing with God. It's like saying that, Lord, you are 100% correct, and I'm 100% wrong. I ask that you cleanse me and purify me. Sabi mo is, huwag akong mag-chismis. You are 100% correct, and I'm 100% in the wrong. Would you forgive me, Lord? So when you confess, you're just agreeing with God that He is in the right. What He says is true, and you disobey so that you will be restored into a right fellowship again with God. Okay? Sabi, if you confess your sin, God is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Okay. So, practical application is confess early. Confess often. Confess fully. Sometimes, meron tayong mga sins that we're dwelling or in-enjoy natin, in-num-num natin, that ayaw pa natin i-give up with the Lord. Sometimes we're even wrestling with God, justifying ourselves that, hindi, tama naman ginagawa ko. Wala namang masama doon. Lahat naman is ginagawa niya. Not because everything is doing the thing. Not because everyone is doing the wrong things makes it right. And not because no one is doing the right thing, it doesn't mean that it's wrong. You have to do the right thing. And we have to confess, so when we realize that we sin against God, we sin against, nakita mo sa Bible, oh, naku, may ano pala to, hindi pala ito yung design ni God sa akin. Lord, sorry, patawarin niyo ako, hindi ko alam. Then confess often. Confess fully. Sometimes we go to God, like a piece of a pie, nag-chop kayo ng part. Lord, sorry po, ito po yung mga kasalanan ko. But you keep something for yourself. You keep darkness sa'yo, thinking that, ako, baka nakalusot ako kay God. But remember kanina yung microchip na ilalagay sa ulo niya, sa brain niyo? God doesn't need a microchip. God knows everything. Would it be easier if we just come clean before God? To confess fully. Na wala kang hinuhold back. Na you have no reason para i-cover pa yung face niyo to save yung face niyo or what. But confess fully before the Lord. One other thing is that confess to one another. It's very important that you also confess to one another. Who among you have accountability buddies? Or somebody that nag-disciple or nag-mentor sa inyo? It's very important as well that meron tayo lahat na accountability buddy or brother in Christ or sister in Christ na mas mature sa atin. That who would pray with us, who would listen, hear from us, and maging accountable din na sabihin na, oh, brother, kamusta na yung progress mo, kamusta na yung struggle mo? That somebody na nilulook up nyo. Sabi sa James chapter 5, verse 16, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another. The prayer of a righteous man is powerful and effective. So when you pray with one another, when you share yung struggle nyo, when you bring the dark into the light, you can be sure that, kumbaga, the darkness will vanish. Okay? Confess early, confess often, confess fully, confess to one another. Okay. To end, let me share, siguro, before I was leading a small group. Tapos sabi ko, I think maganda na magkaroon tayo ng acoustic night. Let's invite friends, non-believing friends. Since ano, kumbaga parang gathering. Para may ma-share din natin yung gospel in a non-threatening way. So, ayun, nag-invite kami ng mga friends, nag-put up kami ng acoustic night, and lahat is nag-invite ng new friends, mga non-believer. Tapos, kumbaga, di, syempre, nag-lilid niya ako, no? Sabi, uy, si, bro, si Kuya Conrad, leader namin. Ako, ay, yan. Kilala naman sa lahat. Tapos sabi, ay, Kuya Conrad, si ano, friend ko. Tapos, ako, uy, ay, sabi, ay, ikaw ang leader nila? Sabi, Christian ka din pala? Ako, oh, bakit? Sabi, eh, kung makasigaw ka sa site, kala mo, parang hindi ka Kristiyano. Sabi ko, baka hindi ako yun. Hindi, sir, ikaw yun. Sabi, nung punta ka sa plant, sa tuwas, ikaw ko yun yun. Talaga ako, kinababahan ako, hindi ko lalang kung gagawin mo. Sa harapan pa nung mga isang Bible study group, kaya sabihan ako ng gano'n. Baka hindi ako yun. Pero ang totoo is ako yun. Nakilala ko siya bigla. Parang binuhusan ng malamig na tubig. Talagang yun. So I kept yung sin na yun. I lied. Walang integrity. Tapos there's anger. There's pride. Talagang gina-justify ko pa yung sarili ko before that. Sabi ko, Lord, tama lang naman. Nasa construction site ako. If hindi ako sumigaw, di ako sinigawan nila. Di ako na lang sisigaw. Tsaka malitin naman yung ginawa nila eh. Tama naman yung ginagawa ko. So it is my job para ano yung tama yun? I wrestled with God for a few weeks. And it's very hard, terrible. I failed miserably. Then, as I wrestled with God, now of course you know who wins. Sabi ko, Lord, mali talaga ako. Naintindihan ko na ngayon na mali talaga ako. Mali yung heart ko. Everything about me is wrong. So I confess to God. I confess to some mga leaders ko above me. Sabi ko that I've been living like this. In anger, in hatred, in pride, and in everything. And then I confess to sa Bible study group ko that I go, it's true that ako yun. Sabi ko, patawarin niyo ako that nag-fail ako sa ganun, nagsinungaling ako sa inyo. So, wala na akong itinago. Ay ko, kasi sumurenda naman ako kay God na. And eventually, na-restore yung everything about me. Na-restore ni God yung joy of fellowship with Him. Yung joy of worship. Yung joy of living a life that without duality. Hindi ka na nabubuhay sa dual life. So, God restored me into a right fellowship again with Him. After that time, so, talagang na-minimize na. Well, I'm not saying that totally is nawala na, but nabawasan na. Hopefully, ngayon din na din. To end up, sabi dito, Psalm 32 verses 1 to 5, blessed is the one whose transgression is forgiven, whose sin is covered. Blessed is the man against whom the Lord counts no iniquity, and in whose spirit there is no deceit. Ito yung nangyari sa akin. For when I kept silent, my bones wasted away through my groaning all day long. For day and night your hand was heavy upon me. My strength was dried up as the heat of summer. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the iniquity of my sin. When you confess, the Lord is faithful. The Lord is just. Just come to Him. Come to Him openly. Tell everything. Sabi dito, my sheep hear my voice and I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish, and no one will snatch them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of the Father's hand. Gagan, kukwestiyonin nyo, when I sin, is God still for me? Can I lose my salvation? Remember this, if you can lose your salvation long ago, you've already lost it. Long ago, remember lang kayo na yung sin? Sa dami nun, you've already lost your salvation. If you can lose your salvation long ago, nawala niyo. But you can't. The truth of the matter is, you cannot lose your salvation. Jesus says, I give them eternal life, and they will never perish, and no one will snatch them out of my hand. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of the Father's hand. No one can snatch you out of the Father's hand. No one can snatch you out of the hand of Christ. When you are in Christ, no one is strong enough. No sin is strong enough than the power of the cross. Lastly, you can be confident of this. Paul says in Romans 38, for I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. You can be sure, you can be certain that no one will be able to snatch you out of the Father's hand, and no one will be able to separate you from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Any questions? Can I lose my salvation?
Bro.
Yes, brother.
I just want to ask, what do you mean about long ago?
Long ago?
I mean, if you're losing your salvation, you have not.
Okay.
It means long ago.
If I can lose my salvation.
Salvation.
If I can lose my salvation long ago, now wala ko na. I mean to say that when I entered into a relationship with Him, saved na ako, nagkasala ako, nawala. Then nagrepent ako, bumalik. Nagkasala ulit, nag-faith. So I mean, the moment pa lang that I step into a relationship with Him and nagkasala ako, na-lost po na yung salvation. If I can lose my salvation long ago, after kong mag-repent about 8 years ago, nawala ko na yung salvation. But I can't. The reality is, I can't lose my salvation. Okay, if wala question, okay. Remember kanina, sabi ko, at least 3 things that you have learned. Then later, go to your group. After 10-minute break, tapos go to your group and discuss among yourselves. And if you have any questions, please feel free to raise. And at the same time, allow me also that to say that I don't know the answer because I'm not all-knowing. Okay, allow me to say that I don't know, or I will get back to you, or maybe our leaders here would can share the answer na hindi ko alam. Is it okay? Okay, 10 minutes break. Parang nasa kids, no? Sunday school. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Sa grupo namin, we're 5, so I'll be sharing siguro 2 each na lang during the entire mobilis. Ay, 1 lang. Ah, 1 lang, sorry. 1 lang pala. 1 lang, yung God will never leave us. And yung illustration ni Brother Conrad, yung immutability ni God, past, present, and future, yun yung learning namin. And the other one is yung relationship and fellowship, yung difference ng dalawa. Na si God, mas mabuti na meron tayong relationship with Him because it's permanent and that's our position with Him. Pero mabuti rin kung meron tayong fellowship with Him kasi that defines yung intimacy natin, yung relationship natin with Him. Tapos another thing, add lang, wala dun sa sinabi niya, God doesn't have favorites, but He has intimate. So we have to really be intimate with God.
God doesn't have favorites, but has intimates. Intimates.
Thank you very much, Sis Irene. Next.
Oh, ikaw na para pumalampak sila. Okay.
Sa aming group, majority of the answers, parang nabi niya, copy-paste. kami sa confession, yung sinabi mo kanina na confession early, often, and fully. Kasi sometimes, late na kami mag-confess kay God, nag-struggle kami, especially sa workplace namin eh. Kasi yung interaction namin sa patient, parang lagi kami china-challenge. So, and one way na anonymous sister na ayan, minsan kasi gina-justify namin yung action namin. Tapos sa yung sinabi mo na yung guard our tongue. So, mostly kasi yung sabi mo nga nag-ignite pa ng fire. So, sa workplace namin parang common lagi yung parang yun. So, but God is loose. Sabi din kami na, actually marami kami natutunan. So, yung...
My voice.
Parang kinokorrect kami instantly ni Lord na, oh, parang mali ito. So, dinidil namin din ako. So, hello.
Thank you, Sis Joy. Then, Jo. Okay, Jo. Thanks, sis Jo. Next. Sino dito? Sino? Kasi yan. Ano?
Brother yata.
Kailan parang ship tayo, si God yung ating shepherd. So He will really guide us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. Then number two,
how handsome yung brother
natin. Same din sa lahat eh. Ayun bro, yung verse na the effective and fervent prayer of the righteous man avails much sa James.
James 5:16.
Ayan, yung latter, in yung latter part. Tapos, okay, so dapat, sure, para tayo maging righteous, we need to believe in the Lord. We need to really have faith in Him. And then, ano pa? Meron kaming question na kakaiba, pero related naman siya sa salvation. Who created sin? Na-discuss na namin kanina.
May kama pa na magtuturo sa akin.
Oo.
Who created sin? Next question? Next question.
Thank you, Yada.
Hello, good evening. Magka-pataka dyan si Conrad, mahalata. Good evening. Na-share lang ng group yung tsaka yung nag-struck din sa akin doon sa teaching ni Kuya Conrad. Yung God is very consistent talaga. Even from the start nung sa forefathers, yung promise niya sa forefathers natin until kay sa time ni Jesus, until now, na He will never forsake us. Yun lang yung medyo nag-struck sa akin. Tsaka yung God is a loving Father talaga. Yung loving and forgiving Father. Na kahit na anong gawin natin, and if we confess and if we return to Him and recognize Him as our Father, He will openly He will receive us with open arms talaga. Tsaka yung agad-agad yung pagtanggap niya. Katulad doon sa prodigal son, di ba? Hindi na tinanong ni nung father niya kung nandito ka pala. Ganyan, di ba? Parang, bigyan na nga na to ng
jacket
to. Artista na to. Ganun. Wala na tanong-tanong si father. Ganun siguro si God sa atin pag ano, nag-confess tayo. Bigyan niya tayo ng jacket. Yan.
Thank you, Brother Mark. Sino po?
Kami po pala yung Chris Angels. Kasi, Chris Angels. So, kasi, yung natutunan namin is, para sa amin is yung grace. So, i-share lang namin, katulad ng sinabi ni Brother Chris, is pag naliligaw tayo or may asawa or may boyfriend or girlfriend, di ba nagpapabango pa tayo or something na kailangan nating suyuin or some. Pero sa Panginoon, siya pa yung nagsusuyo sa atin eh. Siya pa yung nagsusumiksik para paano ba yun? Siya yung nagsusumiksik para mahalin natin siya. Pero hindi dapat yun na eh. Dapat tayo ang magbalik ng love sa kanya. Pero dahil mahal niya tayo, dahil binigyan niya tayo ng loving God na sabi niya, through me, makakapunta kayo sa heaven. So, by His grace, kahit unrighteous tayo, kahit kahit mabantot tayo, or kahit ano naman, hindi na natin kailang magpabango or magpa-impress or magluto ng lechosa. Joke lang. Pero next week, gusto pa namin yun. Hindi joke. Magpa-impress, pero sobrang tahimik kasi, sorry. Pero dahil, yun yung natutunan namin na by His grace and His love, safe tayo. May assurance tayo na pupunta tayo sa heaven. Tama ba? Ay, pwede po ba magtanong?
Opo.
May tanong po kasi na... Hindi pa pa. May tanong na, once safe, always safe ba? Kasi, kunwari, safe ka na as Christian, pero biglang na-fall ka. I mean, hindi literally na na-fall or something, accident, or bigla ka namatay. Pero before ka namatay is gumawa ka ng sin. As in talagang literally na nag-back out ka.
Backslide
or back. And so, safe ka pa rin po ba nun? Or what's the answer?
Now. Next, okay.
Same question. If yung nag-backslide ka ba, are you still safe?
Sagutin natin. Yes, definitely. You're still safe even if you just sing at pagkalabas mo dyan, nabunggo ka. Pinupundol ka. Huwag ka lang sana. No? But because Christ died for you, He paid for your sins, whatever the thing that you did in the past, in the present, and in the future, yung gagawin mo pala, pinatawad niya yun. So, all of your sins are covered by His blood. It was paid by the precious blood of Christ. So that's, no other powers, no other principalities can snatch you away from the hand of God. From hand of Christ. So, believe in God, He paid for everything. So He paid your past, your present, and even your future sins.
Thank you, Brother JR. Okay. Totoo yun. At the same time is, kung ba titingnan natin sa Romans 5 verse 20, sabi doon, when you sin, grace abounds all the more. And when you sin, grace abounded all the more. When you sin, grace abounded all the more. Then, Romans chapter 6 verse 1 said, sabi ni Paul, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sinning so that grace may abound? By no means. How can we who die to sin still live in it? Okay? If we're it's not a license for us to sin in the grace of God because we have already died dun sa sin. And katulad nung sabi ni JR, talagang yung past mo, which is future, na before pa nung sinabi ni Christ, sabi niya yung past, present, and future mo, it's already a future sin, and it's covered by the blood. You just have to go back dun sa, mag-confess mo yung sin mo, and God will restore you. Okay? Thank you, JR!
In short, you lose the fellowship, but you never lose the relationship.
Amen. Okay, clear? Is Dr. Kit agreeing? My wife agreeing.
This is a common question. It's going to come up again and again because we're all human and ask these kinds of questions. So these questions are normal. In a couple of weeks, we're going to have a whole session that's question and answers. And we'll deal with this again, I've got a feeling.
Yes. So get ready with your question, okay? Next na pala. Oh, dito.
As men, we don't want to go bush. Diretso na kami. question na lang diretso. So, Dr. Keith, I have a question regarding if a man who is already saved, since you know most Filipinos back in the Philippines are generally Catholics, so what if this one man has a deep relationship with God, even when still he's a Catholic and practices all the things that are needed for him, but then he has a deep relationship with God? Does he, or is he considered as saved by that time, or does he need to be converted to a Christian in order to be called saved? But I know that conversion does not require the salvation of the person, but is it, as a Catholic practicing all those things, and him having a deep relationship with God, does he have that salvation when he, as given that he has accepted God during that time?
It sort of depends on how things are defined.
You come from a
See, he doesn't want me to talk. This is the third one in just 5 seconds. I got an answer for each one, okay? It sort of depends on how you define things. If his relationship with God is true, valid, if you mean by that, it really doesn't make any difference if he's a Catholic or a Muslim or a Jew. If that relationship is there, that's the important thing. And he would not lose his salvation. Things could happen, sin, etc., where he loses the fellowship. We know that. But that's different than losing the relationship, such as our Father with us as a son. That's a permanent thing. Now, I don't know if I answered your question or not. Does that help, or do you want a follow-up question?
We'll make it more confusing.
You okay? Okay, if we need to, we can talk afterwards.
Actually, this came up from our decrypt study. It's also when we were discussing about salvation. So how, because there was some prominent figure who he was a pastor kid, but then he did a very atrocious sin. So let's say it's like a blasphemic sin. Is that pastor's kid still saved?
English, hindi ko maintindihan.
Well, if he did something terrible like adultery and maybe killing 30 people or something like that, you know. Wait, that's what King David did, and he didn't lose his relationship with God. So, there's no sin that will destroy that relationship. There are sins that will destroy the fellowship. That is true. But just like my dad, I'm his son. It doesn't make any difference what I do. That's always going to be valid. Same thing in the spiritual world.
Thank you.
Okay. You're welcome.
I want to share.
We realize that some of you have questions. So, if you remember the first time we met, the first session, I said you can write it down, and then we'll take it up, and then we can post it doon sa Google Drive where you all have access to, and we will answer it there. Okay? Kasi it's already 9:35. I don't want you to go home at 10 o'clock. So this you know, if you still have questions, please write it down on a piece of paper and give it to me after this lesson.
Thank you, Kuya Mario.
And in a couple of weeks, we'll have a whole evening of question and answers.
Okay, thank you, Pastor Keith, for that. We will have an extra session for Q&A, for questions and answers. So it's not going to be a Wednesday, because we have all scheduled the Wednesday for our lessons. But it will be an extra session for those who are interested to attend. We always have, traditionally, have something like this. Hello? Something like this after the lessons on the Holy Spirit. So we found in the past, a lot of people would have questions after that lesson. So after that lesson, you write down on a piece of paper, just like what we're going to do tonight, write it down on a piece of paper after the lesson on the Holy Spirit, all your questions, and then the following week, we will schedule a session with Pastor Keith, a Q&A session, one whole session, just for him to answer the questions that you asked. Okay? So okay ba yun?
Yes.
Okay. We will post the details in WhatsApp. Okay?
Anyone wants to share? Well, or close it. Close it.
We have, it's 9:37 by my watch. I'm sorry. Maybe one more person who wants to share. Just a quick sharing. Whoever wants to share.
Good evening. Sit nila ako, no? So, napashare nila ako kasi wala na ako by next Wednesday. And, but it's very short, pero this is my first time. Ang share ko lang is about yung napag-usapan namin is the dad's discipline. We normally relate that as a parent na when we talk about discipline, parang takot tayo. Kasi the moment we keep on doing mistakes, or making mistakes, we'll be disciplined by our parents. Tama ba? So, kanina we want to internalize the question kung who wants to be dads, to be disciplined. So now I realize na when God will discipline us, because we don't hit the target and we keep on sinning, that's because we want us to be correct and refined, be a better Christian. As well as being a parent during our childhood, but nagkamali tayo, di ba? Our parent were, because of yung consequence of our actions, because they love us and it will always reflect kung sino yung parent. So as well as in God, as God's disciplining us is because of love. Now He wants also us to walk according to His image. And that's it.
Ay, meron pa ata ang share dun sa... Ay, ano ang mag-share? Si ate yung nag-alaman. So, better we close this in prayer. So before we go, Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you, Father, for this time that you have given us for us to learn about you, about your great love for us. Thank you for comforting us with your word that nothing will be able to separate us from your love. Father, thank you for the assurance of our salvation that every time, Lord, we can just look up to you, to confess to you our sins, because we know that you are faithful and that you are always just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Lord, we pray that as we leave this room, that we be a new man, we be a new
creature, O Lord, that every day there's going to be a transformation, that your word would transform us to be more like you and to be less like of this world. Help us, Lord, and give us the courage to apply your word and even to share your word to others. Salamat for the comfort, salamat for the fellowship with one another and with our intimacy with you. We are very excited for next week's topic, and I pray that everyone, Lord, is maging present. Guide niyo po kami as we go home. In Christ's name, amen.